Hi, my name is Jason Roby. I am an instructor here at the Conservatory of Recording Arts and Sciences. And today I'm going to show you a little bit about sequencing using the pattern sequencer in Logic's UltraBeat. So UltraBeat is one of Logic's built-in instruments. To use it, we need a software instrument track. To create new tracks in Logic, the plus button at the top of the track list. Choose software instrument and create. We need to assign the UltraBeat to the track. So in the far left side, which is known as the inspector in Logic, we see right here where it says instrument, clicking there, and we can choose UltraBeat. For this, we'll go with the stereo version of UltraBeat, which is simply left and right output, and it opens up. So when you first open UltraBeat, it's going to have all types of different controls and various sliders, buttons, and ways of tweaking the sounds for each individual drum. A later video, we'll get into that one and what some of these things do. But for now, what we really want to focus on is the pattern sequencer. In the lower right-hand corner of UltraBeat, there's a button that says Full View. When you hit that, it switches over to see a full view of just the pattern sequencer. A little easier to focus on when we're working on this side of UltraBeat. So a couple things about sequencing in UltraBeat to get started. First thing is you do not want to use the Command Z if you make a mistake for undo. In Logic, Command Z would actually undo adding the UltraBeat as an instrument into the project. So if you make a mistake, you would actually need to undo it just by clicking on whatever you just clicked on to turn it back off. And the other thing is you want to make sure you pick a drum kit to work with before you begin sequencing, because when you change drum kits, it deletes all the sequences that you've made on that that UltraBeat. So before we start anything else, I want to pick a drum kit. At the top of UltraBeat, where it says Factory Default, clicking there, going down to Drum Kits, and I'm more a rock kind of guy for drums, so I'm looking at one of the more live sounding ones. I like the IndieKit Live drum kit. When we load it, it takes a couple seconds to load up all the sounds, and then we can see that there are actually notes already sequenced into it. Whichever drum kit you pick, there's going to be somewhere between 8 and 12 or so sequences already in there, which can be cleared out so you can start from scratch, or you can just choose a blank sequence to start with. In the bottom left corner where it says pattern, this is a menu that you can click on, which lets you choose which pattern you want to sequence into. There's 24 choices, which means that you can have up to 24 different patterns for different sections of your song in one instance of the UltraBeat. The ones that say SQ by them are ones that already have notes sequenced into them. I'm going to go ahead and pick the first one, even though it's already got some notes in there, and just clear it out. To clear a sequence, the same place where we just chose our pattern, you would control click and choose clear. So what we're looking at, if you've never seen any kind of pattern sequencer like this before, most software DAWs will have something similar to this. We see on this side a list of all the different drum sounds UltraBeat's got, and along the horizontal axis, we've got 32 different steps that we can write drum notes into. So these 32 steps can represent different types of notes, either 8th note, 12th note, 16th, 24th, or 32nd notes. Now, if you know anything about music theory, you probably know that a 12th note and a 24th note don't actually exist. That's how Logic denotes triplets. So I'm just going to leave it at the default, which is a 16th note. If I leave my sequence as being 32 steps long, that means that this entire UltraBeat screen will represent two bars of music. You can, however, change the length of the sequence by sliding this bar around. It can't go longer than 32 steps, but you can shorten it as short as you want to. I'm going to leave it at the default 32 steps for now. And when I want to start putting some notes into it, if I'm sequencing drums to go with instruments that are already recorded, I can either play my song in the background and actually draw the notes into Ultrabeat as the song plays, or I can start by drawing the drums in first and then playing the other instruments to it. So in order to get the sequencer, the pattern sequencer working in here, there is a power button on Ultrabeat that has to be turned on. And then next to it is the play button. If you hit the play button, the rest of the instruments in the song don't play, just Ultrabeat plays. If we hit spacebar to play, then we hear the rest of our instruments and Ultrabeat plays along with it so that we can sequence along to it. So starting off with the kick drum, if I want to throw a couple kicks in, of course I can hear my song playing along, so I know that a kick should go probably here, and probably here. I'm going to throw in a couple more, a couple other places that make sense. Then we'll throw in a couple of snare drums by going on the snare lane, and let's see, maybe throw them right here. Actually, no, go back to this bar. Throw in a couple at the end. Now, I would like to have a hi-hat playing along on the eighth notes with this song. That would take an awful lot of clicking to make it happen. So the easy way, a couple of shortcuts you'll find in Ultrabeat. It's actually a lot of shortcuts you'll find if you use the control key and click around on things. So for this one, if we look for the closed hi-hat lane, which is right here, if I hold control and click anywhere along the lane, a menu pops up with options like add every downbeat, and then I can also control click and choose add every upbeat. Now, with two clicks, I've got hi-hats on each eighth note. Although I'm going to take this one out and replace it with an open hi-hat. So if I want to have another pattern, like say a chorus pattern that's maybe slightly different than my verse, you can choose a different pattern at the bottom here and start from scratch, which means clearing it out. Or we could actually copy the first pattern into it and then make some changes, which for this song I think makes a little bit more sense because it's pretty straightforward start to finish. The song's rhythmically pretty much the same. So to copy this pattern, if we hold control and click on the pattern list once again, choose copy, and then move over to the next pattern, control click and choose, control click and choose paste. There's the pattern, which I can now make some changes to so that my chorus might be slightly different than my verse. So I'm thinking the main difference I want to make is making the hi-hat part be a ride cymbal instead. So another control click shortcut. If you control click over one of the names of the drums in this list, you can choose copy, and then click on the one you want to copy it onto, control click again, and we're going to go with paste sequence. And I want to use the last one I did, which is the last one that's lit up on my list here. And there it is. More snares on it. A couple of simple changes like that. Now, if I go back to my verse part, there was one thing that was a little bit annoying on it, in that the hi-hat, although all the notes are in the exact right place, they sound just a little bit too robotic and perfect because the velocity is the same on each one of these. So it's playing the exact same sample of the exact same hi-hat for the entire performance. So down here at the bottom of Ultrabeat, this whole section, these bars, however tall they are, is going to represent what velocity they are being played at. So you can either manually go in and move a couple of them around, or again, control clicking for shortcuts, you can choose alter velocity, which alters the velocity of every note on that lane. This is only for the hi-hat, by just a little bit, just to give it a little bit more human realistic of a feel. So once I've got something that I am happy with, I like it for use in my song, there are two ways that I can make this now work with the song, have the patterns change when I want them to and play along. One way is using a MIDI controller keyboard. To do this, at the bottom center where it says pattern mode, we turn that on, and then next to it where it says toggle by default, I'm going to switch it to toggle on step one. What that does is makes it so that when you trigger the pattern change, it will change at the beginning of the next pattern, so your timing doesn't have to be perfect in changing the patterns. So for this, I've got a controller keyboard next to me that, well, how do I know which note to hit on the controller for each pattern that I want? Once again, at the bottom where this pattern list is, by each pattern, it says this is pattern number one, and in parentheses, C minus one, which means that the C note in the minus one octave on the keyboard will trigger this pattern to play. And then the second pattern I used, C sharp in the minus one octave, and so on up the line. So if I want the first, my verse pattern to play, I will hit the C minus one key on my keyboard. We'll let the song start playing. And when it starts getting to the chorus, which is going to start here at bar nine, I'll hit the C sharp minus one key. As long as I hit it any time after the eighth bar starts, it will start automatically on bar nine. And there it changes. And then once again, when I'm ready to go back to the verse, which is at bar 13, I seem to hit that C minus one key sometime before bar 13, after bar 12 starts. This also can be recorded into the performance. So when we are ready to record our pattern into the song, one thing I think is really important in doing this, makes things a lot easier, is if you back the beginning of the song up just a little bit so that you don't miss that first downbeat. To do that, right here in the top corner of the arrangement screen, you can back it up just a tad. I'll just make things a little easier on us. When we hit the R key for recording, I hit the C minus one key on my keyboard, and it begins playing the pattern. When we get to bar eight, the chorus starts on bar nine. So anytime after bar eight begins, I can hit the C sharp minus one key. And the change will actually happen then right on bar nine. Same thing to go back to my verse. After bar 12, I hit the C minus one key, and then at bar 13 is when it will actually change. Notice in the arrangement area that we have not actually recorded all the notes of the pattern into this region. This is just recording the notes that triggered the switches to happen. So this way, if you want to go back and make any changes to your patterns, you can still do that in UltraBeat, and those patterns will be reflected when you play it back. The other way that we can get the patterns into our song is to drag and drop them from UltraBeat into the song. Down here at the bottom left-hand corner, where it says pattern, there's this little box that when you hover over it, says drag to arrange window. Choose the pattern that you want to use. I'm going to start with the verse. Click that box, drag it onto your arrangement window. And there's our pattern. Since it's only a two-bar pattern and my verse is eight bars long, if you hold option and drag it a couple times, you make a couple copies. And I'll switch to my second pattern and do the same thing, dragging it to bar nine and just making one copy of it. The advantage of doing it this way is that now if I want to make some changes that you can't really do in UltraBeat, like if I want to move things a little bit off of these grid lines, can't do that in UltraBeat, but now I can do that in the individual regions. Only thing to keep in mind here is that when you drag the regions into the main arrangement, you want to turn the power button off on your UltraBeat so that it doesn't continue to play along also the pattern with your regions. And now, there they are. This is also the way you would want to save your work if you wanted to change drum kits at this point. Because like I said earlier, it does delete the patterns that you worked in from UltraBeat, but these regions would not be affected by that. So if I want to now change to, say, the Ghost Town kit. A completely different feel for the song. And that is how you sequence using Logic's UltraBeat Pattern Sequencer. We'll be right back.